ticket.
Look at me short. Look at me short. I'm the captain now.
Three-time national champion, Vershawn Jackson.
Oh, I got a bunch all alone is Vershawn Jackson. And Vershawn, he'll get it to the 24-yard line.
Coming at you live from the Koppel Chevrolet GMC studios in the heart of Lincoln, America. On air and online at theticketfm.com. Presented by Wingstop. Here he is, Vershawn Jackson.
Ah, yeah!
Did you miss me? This is the captain, www.wingstop.com. We're back in the building, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you can hear me. One day in the wake up. Can you hear me?
Oh, you can hear you.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, dang. Well, come on, man. Get it together. One day in the wake up, and it's here. Another night game. I thought we played well at night.
You think so?
I think
we didn't get Indiana.
We did. What do you mean? We won last two night games.
That's true. Yeah.
Huh?
Do you like night games?
I love night games. That clip is from a night game. Can y'all hear that?
Mm-hmm.
You can?
We can hear you. Yeah.
Okay. Good. But that catch that on the intro was from a night game, Kansas. Listen, Memorial Stadium is awesome at night. But to go on the road, we went to Okie State. Was that at night?
Yeah.
Come on, man. You know when you go in and dominate somebody at night and then get on a plane, like, holler at your boys. We'll be right back.
Yeah, I'm not really. I like daytime. It's just something like playing in the day. You know, I guess I was used to it. So we only played, what, three games in my 2 years here? We played like three games at night.
Really?
And none in Lincoln, though, at night. You know what I'm saying? We didn't even play at night in Lincoln. We played nights elsewhere, but not in Lincoln.
Well, I got one in Lincoln. A couple.
Yeah.
One for sure. Kansas game. It was good. Yeah.
Well, we went down to Kansas one of them years when they was like 9-0. They was like ranked number five. I mean, no, they wasn't ranked number five, but they were like top 10.
Yeah, I think it was 95.
Yeah. Yeah. So I think we went down to Kansas. It was like 3-0 at halftime. And then we came back and beat like 33 to zip, you know. So
yeah, this is kind of my halftime report. Listen, we're 3-3.
Mm-hmm.
Is that our record? Whoever would have thunk we'd be 3-3 at this junction four games ago. We thought we were gonna be just like, what is going on? It was gonna be woe is me. And here we are. Here we are. Halftime, halfway point, and we have an opportunity to lead the Big Ten West. Really? How did we get there?
I wouldn't say lead, I'd say tied.
Well, no. I think there's another game. I think of Minnesota or Illinois. I think Illinois has to beat Minnesota or something or the other. The other way around. Minnesota has to beat Illinois.
We still win.
Beat Purdue.
We have a tiebreaker over Illinois because they lost to Indiana. So yeah, we will be.
I don't think the tiebreaker extends that way.
Yeah, I mean, hey, why not?
That's a really long way of getting to the
tiebreaker
for week seven.
Nobody thought, you know, at that point, you don't know what the season has to hold. It just goes to show you how well of a job that coaching staff is doing. Coach Joseph and all of the coaches, I think they're doing a good job. They got to do a better job. Offensive line has got to get going. I would love to see the big Bryce, you know, put him in the phone booth, put him at right guard, and let the big body go. Tell him to get his butt down and then just drive people. You know, I would love to see that happen because – if that happens and we can get somebody out there on the outside at right tackle and shore this lineup. I mean, we got one sack, but we had 17 knockdowns. You get that in order where you have no sacks and maybe five knockdowns. I'm showing you a team that has an opportunity to go a long way, at least on the west side.
Yeah.
Do we feel like, I mean, I know it's, you know, maybe it's not at that point quite yet, but is there going to be a game like Oklahoma? It felt like the offensive line was so overwhelmed that even though Casey Thompson's the better quarterback, maybe somebody with a little bit more mobility might be a better option. Now, all I'd have to admit, when the guys, the backups have had their chances, I think they both, you know, kind of fumbled them away so far this year. So maybe that's less of the opportunity that you want to give them moving forward. But, you know, I between that and the shots that he's taken, I think those guys got to be ready.
Well, you know, I think Casey should talk to his dad. His dad was a pretty good running quarterback. So, you know, sometimes he just needs to take off. You know, it's a matter of time from him just sitting back in the pocket for so long that the pressure caves in on him. Not the pressure, but the linemen cave in on the defensive DN. So, you know, he needs to get away a little quicker or just take off. You know, I mean, I would like to see him run like Adrian Martinez, but I don't want the turnovers like Adrian Martinez.
Are you crazy? You got to be crazy, Black Shirt.
I mean, I would like to see him do this morning.
I mean, what you told me you didn't have any sleep. I said you didn't have any sleep, and that was I don't have any sleep moment.
We do not want
him to run like no Adrian Martinez. Like him to
not like run like Adrian Martinez, but I would like for him to run a little bit more. I mean, he's sitting back there taking shots after shots. Sometimes, you know, you got to get out of that pocket and skedaddle. You know, I ain't sitting there and just letting it cave in on you and losing. Then you put your team in a bad situation. So the thing is, he need to just, you know, if you don't see it after 3-4 seconds, hey, get out of there. You know, I'm pretty sure Whipple told him that the same thing too. And if not, man, you're going to end up right on the sideline in a wheelchair just sitting rolling around because you need to get rid of that ball, how much punishment he done took.
Yeah.
I agree. You definitely – but he needs to know when to run. When he does run, get down.
And with
try to take the big shot, man. Don't try to be a hero. That's not what he is. He can run. I think he's got the skills to run. I just want him to be able to protect himself when he does run and make sure he protects the ball.
And one thing I say last week, what they did great was flaring that running back out. Now, if the teams catch on to that, that would make it easier for Casey to bust up the middle because that linebacker probably will go with him. You know, if that's man coverage. So you're opening it up opportunity for him to get 6-7 yards a carry, you know, just to get us closer to the first down. Now, if that happened, that's great. But if not, then you flare it out to Grant and let him run down there and truck somebody again and make another highlight film for himself.
Yeah, and I do like – I think the play action to the tight end, you know what I mean, off some type of run fake is there all day long. We scored off of that, especially in the red zone. We scored off of that. It was 90-something-isk, you know, being able to fake that run, tight end running. He was – Volklik was by himself. So we got
the Fadone. What's his name? Thomas Fadone. Is he back? He's back?
I haven't seen anything reported about that, but I know he's getting closer.
I mean, last week he was 95% ready to go. So, hey.
He didn't suit, though, did he?
I don't know. So they were talking about it earlier today, and I just know they say he's a good blocker. So you know, maybe that we can use that help if we could. You know, I know he's not gonna be able to be like a guard or a tackle, but you know, we still can use it for a tight end.
And I get that part, but you know, it's gonna take some time for Fadone to get back into the swing of things. You know, sitting out as long as he's been out, you got to think. He's been out a long time. Spring, he wasn't there, you know, that long at all before he went down. So it's going to take him a little bit to feel how it is to block again, to make sure that the knee is strong. And but he gives you everything. He gives you everything. Good block.
So perfect.
Hold on a minute. Hold on, Terrell. Hold on, Black Shirt. We got a special guest with us. We got a special guest. My friend, little disc jockey, Jock Allen.
Hello.
What are you doing, Jock? Where are you?
Just driving around, taking in the sights of beautiful Southwest Missouri.
Small town, big town, where?
I'm in Seneca.
Yeah, I don't know where that's at.
Seneca, Missouri. I know. Nobody knows where that is.
Give me your halftime report We haven't talked in a while. Six games in, three with Coach Frost, three with Coach Joseph. Give me your report. What say you, Jock Allen?
Okay, so three wins. I think Mickey Joseph is good for our program right now. I think the players need a boost from someone that has looked from the outside in and is bringing back the structure and the morale that is needed to be successful at the University of Nebraska. Next question.
Dang, did you hit me with the next question? Is that what you're doing now, Jock?
You know, I know time is precious.
Okay. So now, you know, Scott was 1-2. Mickey's 2-1. And I really don't give him that Oklahoma because he took that situation in 5 days, and anybody worth their salt would be tough for them to call a different. Excuse me.
Not his fault.
No, but now that we're 2-0, we're going to Purdue. How do we win against Purdue? What's the differences? Let me backtrack. What are the differences between Coach Frost, been here 4.5 years, you watch the games, and Coach Joseph, been here for 3 games?
Okay. Okay. All right, boys. You're getting straight to the point there. Well, got to be honest. It is an attitude. It is the way you are supposed to feel going into each game. Okay? I think Coach Joseph, I'm going to call him Coach Joseph, gives them a feeling that we can win. I think, and like, you know, no disrespect to Scott Frost, but Mickey, I feel, in my opinion, lets these boys know they can win these games. They can win these games. I think morale is screwed up. But Mickey gives them a feeling that they can win these games.
That's all you got? You're a little dry today, Jock. What's wrong with you?
Well,
you're in Seneca.
All right, here.
Home of the Seneca High School Indians.
That I'm watching kneeling down, biting his fingernail. Does that seem like he's in his team?
No. Well,
they need someone that is as enthusiastic as he is at the beginning of the game. He needs to be that through the whole game, all 4 quarters. I'm not going to show you. If I'm a head coach, even if I'm nervous, my team should never see that. Coach is biting his nails.
The mentality to win is different. The mentality to want to win is different. I think they're practicing different. Reason why I know that, even though I don't have to go, because on Saturdays when I see us making open field tackles, when I see us being inspired, when I see us controlling themselves to not want to get all juiced up after they make one little play in a game of thousands of plays, you get happy after the game. You dance after the game. You do all those things that you do after you win the game, not during. You get excited.
Because that is what you call short-term goals. It's also called someone that hasn't been coached the right way, that they're taking their individual action as best part of the game.
Jock, that's all you got for us? You got anything else? I thought you had your homeboy with you.
Let's say Joe Mickey Joseph, Joe Big Red, fight. Don't ever give up. Whatever is in your head, let that stuff go. You are not what you know you are. These boys have been cheated. Let this, Coach Joseph show you what you're supposed to be, what you're worth. Play like you're worth it. Play each down like you're worth it. Go Big Red.
You need to go eat a sneaker jock or something. You need to wake yourself up this morning. You ain't the jock. That ain't the jock I know.
He's done.
He hung up on me. Most of the times I hang up on him, but he hung up on me. Hey, Jock said he ain't coming in to be funny. He coming in to be serious today. Eric 84 says, did you watch the first half against Rutgers, VJ? LOL, not good. Did you watch the first half, Black Shirt?
Rutgers? I mean, we can't get in a hole. We can't get in a hole period anymore this year. We can't be down 14 zip or 13 zip, whatever it was. But you get to the hardcore this conference schedule, and these teams are putting numbers up, and you don't want to get behind low like that with a team with a good defense that can hold your offense. So, you know, you got to play smart football on special teams, punt the ball, even field punts and kicking punts and stuff. So it's got to be a special team. It's got to go back and forth, but we got to win it some way or the other, you know, either offense or defense. But we can't get put in a hole quick like we did last week.
Yeah, Eric, I mean, I appreciate that, what you said, that I watched the first. Of course I watched the first game. I mean, you watched the first half, right, Eric? I mean, everybody watched the first half of the game. But it's funny that you would pick the worst part of that game to text in about. How about text in about the second half comeback? How about text in about the fact that the defense didn't give up another point? How about text in about the fact that we picked the ball off three times? How about text in about that? How about that? And that's not drinking a Kool-Aid. That's you asking a dumb question. Did you watch the first half of the Rutgers game? Come on, Eric. Get for real. We knew it wasn't good. Everybody in the state, in the country that watched the game, know the first half wasn't good. But you know what was even better? And I don't even remember the first half of the game. All I remember is the second half comeback.
I did. I walked around the whole house.
At halftime?
No, at third, fourth quarter, man. I just couldn't sit and watch it. I peek at TV when pacing. I walk around. I was pacing like, come on now. Then they threw the touchdown. There we go. I was hyped then, you know. I was doing my little dance in the living room, so.
Wait, before we go off, sorry, Eric. Eric said it was a response to you saying that we pay better at night. And then you know what he says? Stop yelling at me, Captain.
You're cyberbullying. All right. Yeah. No cyberbullying today.
Eric, I'm sorry. If you want two tickets to a game, let me know. I'll take care of you, sir.
Nice guy.
It's the captain on the ticket, www.wingstop.com. We have chicken sandwiches of all flavors and kinds. Get there before they run out again. And in the words of Coach McBride, run it again. It's the captain I'm with.
The Black Shirt.
And
Coven.
Be right back.
Nebraska fans, it's almost time for college football season. Brokers Insurance Agency in Lincoln is a proud donor of Nebraska Athletics. Brokers Insurance Agency is located at 33rd and A Streets in the heart of Lincoln. At Brokers, they can help you with all your insurance needs. Let them worry about your insurance so you have more time to enjoy the college football season. Call one of their licensed agents today at 402-420-5353 or visit their website at brokersinsuranceNE.com. Go Big Red!
Hi, Sean Callahan here for Copple Chevrolet GMC, and things are cooking here in Louisville. We are really hitting on all cylinders right now, and deals are off the charts. We've got a lot more new 2022 and 2023 Chevrolet and GMC inventory than we've had in a long time. So make sure you check us out online, or do even better, stop on in the store and let us show you one in person. Our pre-owned lot is plumb full, so take that short money-saving drive down 144th Street or check us out online at copplecars.com. You'll be glad you did.
At Allo, we think you deserve the fiber things in life. Like binging your favorite TV shows and movies buffer-free, next-level, lag-free gaming, and video calls without frozen faces. So say goodbye to lag and buffering, and hello to super-fast fiber internet with dedicated 24/7 support for total peace of mind. Plus, no hidden fees, no expiration dates, and no contracts, ever. From dependable service to exceptional support, experience the fiber things with Allo. Go to allofiber.com/fiberthings and switch today.
You know that feeling after a good, hearty meal? The worries of the world just slip away. Time slows down. Nothing but good times and good company. That's what you get with Mary Ellen's Food for the Soul. Mary Ellen's does food right with a menu that includes smoked wings, pulled pork, brisket, catfish, and don't sleep on their sides, shrimp and grits, collard greens, baked beans. It's food that makes your heart happy. Mary Ellen's Food for the Soul, just east of 27th and Pineland. Let them fix you a plate.
At first, I was really nervous and intimidated to buy a ring. I wasn't sure what I was getting into.
My experience with Starter Heyman was very easy. I felt like I walked out of Starter Heyman with the ring that was going to make her go wow and say yes.
I love my ring. It is so beautiful.
I absolutely love my ring. I get compliments on it all the time. I always tell them Starter Heyman.
Yeah, we would definitely recommend Starter Heyman.
Yeah, it was great.
We're definitely coming back in the future.
Starter Heyman Jewelers, Lincoln and Grand Island, SauterHeyman.com.
Hey, it's Sean Callahan, and football season is here, and there is one place that has all the games plus great food and beer specials. Tanner's Bar and Grill at 30th and Yankee Hill. Whether it's Thursday night football, college football Saturdays, NFL Sundays, or Monday night football, there's a great view of the game from any seat with different food and drink specials every night. Try the Blue Ribbon Reuben Sandwich or the Prime Rib French Dip or any of their famous chicken wings. That's Tanner's Bar and Grill at 30th and Yankee Hill.
People always ask, what are Jake and Sip like when they're off the air? Well, the answer probably won't surprise you.
Hey, Jake, your Honda's looking a little dirty.
Says the guy whose license plate is barely visible.
I mean, do you even care about that thing anymore?
It gets a little uncomfortable. Now that's when I jump in.
Hey, whoa, Mark, did you get a new car?
Nope, just took my car down to Nebraska Auto Detail. Joe and the staff made the outside and the inside look amazing. Maybe you guys need to go.
Okay, wise guy.
Settle down, Jake.
Book your appointment today at NebraskaAutoDetail.com.
College football in Lincoln, America. The time has come. Start your game day off right with the A1 Automotive Ticket Tailgate Pregame Show. Join the ticket crew live from Tipsy Tina's in the Haymarket as they bring you all the coverage you need to get you ready for the action. It's the A1 Automotive Ticket Tailgate Pregame Show on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Brought to you by A1 Automotive, Mullen Motors, Wall to Wall Wine and Spirits, Bauer Underground, Ben Bleicher with Professional Realty Group, and Ritchie Brothers.
This is your High School Minute.
With your Southeast Community College High School Minute, I'm Harrison Arns. In volleyball this week, on October 11th, Lincoln Northeast took a loss to Grand Island in a sweep. Lincoln Northstar won its matchup against Lincoln Southeast in four sets, and Lincoln Pius X keeps its hot streak going by taking down Kearney in a sweep. Laney Brott led the Thunderbolts with 16 kills, while Addison Markowski had 40 assists. Lincoln Southwest won over Fremont in three. Brindley Christensen led the Silverhawks with 11 kills, and Skyler swept Lincoln Northwest. Switching the girls' state golf, on Tuesday, Lincoln Southwest currently leads with 645 strokes. Lincoln East sits at second with 655 in high school football. On Thursday, Millard West will take on Lincoln Southwest, and Friday, Lincoln North Star will face Lincoln East. Both games will kick off at 7 p.m. and be covered right here on 93.7 The Ticket. This has been your Southeast Community College High School Minute. Learn more today at southeast.edu with locations in Lincoln, Beatrice, Milford.
There's a lot of realtors in Lincoln, but don't get overwhelmed by all the names. Ben Bleicher with Professional Realtor Group at Berkshire Hathaway Ambassador Real Estate is your go-to option when buying or selling residential and commercial property. Ben's team offers unbeatable customer service and promises to make the buying and selling process as stress-free as possible. Call Ben today at 402-419-6309 for all your real estate needs. Ben Bleicher with Professional Realty Group at Berkshire Hathaway Ambassador Real Estate. No pressure, just professionalism.
Hello, everybody. I'm Charlie Stone, and joining me in just a moment is Andy Goodyear, General Manager of Honda of Lincoln. But before I bring Andy on, I need to tell you about something that really got my attention. Just the other day, I saw on television Andy announcing that in the last 50 years, they had sold and serviced close to 100,000 vehicles.
Thanks, Charlie. Yeah, actually, the number would be a lot higher if we add in how many repeat customers we have for service and that come back to buy cars from us over and over and over again.
Now, Andy, tell everybody about your special offer.
Well, as most people know, always trade for vehicles. But now we're offering for people to come in and sell us their cars. We're ready to buy, bring it on in, whether it's a year old or a few years old, and we'll pay them cash that same day. It'll be hassle-free, and we'll do it the Honda of Lincoln way.
Come experience the Honda of Lincoln way of buying cars, 27th and Yankee Hill Road, or online at hondaoflincoln.com.
93.7 The Ticket, Fox KFXL Weather, sponsored by Security First Bank, a relationship you can count on.
Windy conditions will be in place yet again today as northwest winds could gust over 40. A red flag warning will be in effect this afternoon due to critical fire danger as we see an afternoon high of around 61. A few passing clouds tonight with a low of 40. It will be windy again tomorrow, but slightly warmer with a high of 71. I'm meteorologist Tim Wright for 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, sponsored by Wingstop.
Okay, Bart. Let it play. Joe Backmire, Travis, Dragon B762, appreciate you guys on the YouTube stream. All right. Okay, so let me get to some of these texts real quick, and then we'll get to something else that's a little bit more interesting.
We do have Bob on the line. Do you want to get to Bob too?
Put Bob on. Bob's been gone for a while. Come on, Bob.
Hey guys, how you doing?
Awesome.
What up, Bob?
Hello.
Yeah, we're doing well. There? Yeah, how are you doing?
Hey, I'm doing all right. Hey. 2-0. We got Purdue this week. You know, I like the black shirts, the way they're playing, the way they played the last two games. Lights out in the second half. You know, we can put pressure on this quarterback and make life miserable for him. Get that offense, get it clicking again, and you know. I have said from the beginning, and I'm not backing down, there's not a team we can't beat. But one game at a time right now, Purdue. Let's take it to Purdue this week. We got a week off. Then we got Illinois. But, you know, I still say, everybody's saying, well, you know, this and that about the Big Ten West. You know, why can't a one-loss team win it? You know, Nebraska can still win it. And run the table, one loss, okay? I love our chance. I love Coach Mickey, new sheriff in town, his deputy, Bill Bush, got that defense rolling. Hey, now let's get the offense kicking back in, and let's see where it goes. You know,
all right. Well, hey, give me your best go, Big Red Bob. Appreciate you.
Bob will destruct it.
Give me your best go, Big Red Bob. Hurry.
Go, Big Red.
There we go.
3-1. Terrell, you got to keep counting down. Once you start the countdown, they better get the talking fast. You keep the countdown going. I'm gonna put the pressure on while you counting them down. Willie 84 says Smothers fumble. I only remember one play and it was positive. Love Thompson, but give Smothers, give me more Smothers. I agree with that. I think Smothers gives you a different dimension. Why not put a Smothers package in? The Smothers package. Everybody, when you put your Smothers package in, it's Smothers and whoever else you want to be. You know, it should be some guys that'll hit you in the mouth. I like to see who I think is the most underrated blocker on Nebraska's football team. Y'all know who I'm going to say. He's a tight end. Chancellor.
Yeah.
That's right. Underrated. Big time. I want to see more from him. I hope he gets more catches. You guys got anything to that? Because I don't want to just.
Well, I think it's worth a shot, too, with a struggling offense. Usually, I mean, you don't see, sometimes you'll see it. I mean, the best package that I can think is Tim Tebow when he came in for Chris Leak. That was a championship team. But for a lot of it, times it's, you know, kind of a struggling offense just to get a different look out there. I wouldn't mind to see, a Logan Smothers package here and there. They seem to go to it a little bit earlier this year. Haven't gone back to it. But, yeah, I'd like to see it come back.
Yeah, like. I would say something like a second down two situation, you know, just surprising with the option. You know, I know many teams ain't practiced for it the way we run it. So, you know, that'll be a big change up. I believe they get a lot of yards too. And sometimes he can fool them with the pitch because they're probably not going to expect him to pitch it. But if he do pitch it, Grant will be right there to run it about 70, 80 yards. So it's a good package they need to throw in every series of game, I think. I mean, every series of quarter, I would say. Mm. You know, I mean, just them up.
I agree. 100%. The Smothers package. Mickey, yeah. The Smothers. Coach, whip the Smothers package, baby. Don't let the young man just, you know. I know we got a backup in Purdue, but or Purdy, my bad. Not Purdue. In Purdy, but I'm saying, you know, I mean, Smothers, man. Do you know you will electrify? Here's what 6573 says. I like this. Want to know what makes me nervous for this game? The opportunity it gives us as we win. It's a massive opportunity for Mickey in the program. A win against Purdue away at night, massive win. Run enough to draw a spy, nothing more with Casey, I mean. The first one.
It's big for the university. It's big for everybody. You know, it's big for the state of Nebraska if we can get this win. I'm not going to put a big if on it, but we just need to go down there and play smart football. You know, I mean, the game is played in four quarters, so we got to play all four quarters to be perfect. Not to be perfect, but to play a perfect game. You know, we can't take a quarter off and think that we can make it up in the end, because sometimes time run out fast. But we need to get down there and play a great defense. We need to play smart on the offensive side, smart on the defensive side. We need to get Casey some great blocking, you know, block like you never blocked before in your life. And I think everything else will take care of itself, because we got better athletes than them. We just got to be out coaching.
Yeah, and the more I hear everybody say, "Oh, we gotta get the line fixed." The more the game, the more the game and the season progresses, I think that they're gonna get better. You don't take when you have great coaches that love you, that want to see you do as well as you can. You don't take steps back usually. If you do, then you get replaced. That's just the way. That's the way it has to be. If the former players, if we want to see us get back to where we're winning games, it's because we strive for perfection on the football field. And if you was making mistake over mistake over mistake, you would get an opportunity. But at some point, don't you got to look at a guy that won't make a mistake? Mistake-free football. Smart football, physical football. Randy says this. Go ahead.
Oh, I was just saying that. I think too, I think we all believe Nebraska's got a chance in any of these remaining games. Nobody's overwhelming. But Nebraska's got to play close to that second half as opposed to the first half and against Rutgers. It needs to be some clean ball. That's what a lot of these teams do, is they kind of just step out of your way, play clean football themselves, maybe not overwhelm you with talent, and then have you beat yourself. And Purdue's kind of outside of that. Again, Purdue, not your normal Big Ten West team, so we could see if, you know, you might be able to get away with a few more turnovers this week if you can cause them on the other end. But, I think it still stands. I mean, I think Nebraska fans, as we feel pretty good about this game going in as the opportunity and all that, but it's still, I mean, you look at the spread, it's close to two touchdowns. So this would be a monumental win.
I mean, 13 and a half.
Yeah.
And my heart still hasn't wavered. And I don't think theirs is too. You know, when those guys start to take on the mentality of the coach that's coaching them, where they're focused, they're honed in, they know the mission. Nothing else is more important than the mission. That's why you came to Nebraska, for the mission. What's the mission? Right now, beat Purdue. Long term, win the West. Have an opportunity to play for the Big Ten championship. Oh my goodness, how monumental would that be? Do we do to Mickey, Coach Joseph, what we've done to so many other guys, athletes before, i.e. my hometown, Omaha? We wait to the last minute to make them feel like they are a part of the family and that there is a possibility that we want you. You don't even got to tell me you want them. You make them feel like it's a possibility that they want you. And take care of your own backyard. But you can't wait all the way. You know, when I say take care of, I'm saying either pay the man or sign the man. Either way, it's the same. It's the same. That's just how I feel. And so, I was going to read something. Let me read something real quick, because I think it's I like Stacey A. Griffin. I like this. She says this, or he. Perfection is unrealistic. Absolutely. To people who think it's unrealistic. We need to be relentless in our pursuit of excellence. I agree with that, Stacey. We need to get better at all aspects of the game, the plays, the discipline, the mind game, beat your opponent. Well, when you do all that at the peak performance, then that's what happens, right?
Yep, that's
right.
When you play with discipline, you play smart ball. You know, you don't let too many things distract you. And that's what we need to do. We need to play that kind of that discipline in the first quarter and second quarter and third quarter and fourth quarter. It just makes it a complete game. You know, and the defense got to go out there and relax early, and the offense got to relax. We got to learn how to play four quarters, and I think we win.
Dragon B says this. Love you too, Captain Classmate. I don't know who this is right now, but I will. This is game week. I don't. NU 24, Purdue 17. We running the ball to win. I like that. Who is the coach? The coach is already in the building. We got rid of this sickness. We healing and winning at healing. Praise Magic Mickey.
I got one coming up for you when we come back from break, Captain.
What you got? A song?
Yeah.
You do? Can you tell me what's the genre?
This is Cameron right here.
I know that, but this ain't the one that you got me. I know who this is. I don't know why we always play these. Who says we can play these songs? Who gives
is this song?
Who put this in here? Bach or Terrell? Which one of y'all?
Come on now,
this one in here.
Bach or East Coast Bach, guy.
Get it out of here. Get it out of here. Terrell, what do you want to change that to?
Put it on, Bach.
Oh, you're
right. Put it on.
Yeah. Check it out. See, the only thing you need to do right here is snarl your freaking head.
Yeah, Bob. Yeah. I teach you about some music, Bob.
There we go.
Yeah. Break your freaking neck, boy. You mean take it out?
Yeah. Take it out. Yeah. Here we
go. This is the ticket. We at 93.7. I'm with the captain in the box, and I'm the black shirt. We'll be back after these commercials. Just give it away. Yeah, here we go now. Tell me what you really want to do. Come here, man. Talk to me. You look like you're gonna give it to us. I know what you're talking about. You're trying to walk for me. The way you really try to put it on the job. Doing it like I never did before for me. The way you break your back and I break your neck. And the way you try to put it on the
local businesses are excited to show you what they're made of at this year's Lincoln Expo, presented by the Lincoln Chamber of Commerce. Stop by Pinnacle Bank Arena from 10 a.m. until 3 p.m. on Wednesday, October 19th. More details at our website, lcoc.com.
This is your High School Minute.
With your Southeast Community College High School Minute, I'm Harrison Arns. In volleyball this week, on October 11th, Lincoln Northeast took a loss to Grand Island in the sweep. Lincoln Northstar won its matchup against Lincoln Southeast in four sets.
and Lincoln Pius X keeps its hot streak going by taking down Kearney in a sweep. Laney Brott led the Thunderbolts with 16 kills, while Addison Markowski had 40 assists. Lincoln Southwest won over Fremont in 3. Brindley Christensen led the Silverhawks with 11 kills. And Skyler swept Lincoln Northwest. Switching to girls' state golf, on Tuesday, Lincoln Southwest currently leads with 645 strokes. Lincoln East sits at second with 655 in high school football. On Thursday, Millard West will take on Lincoln Southwest, and Friday, Lincoln North Star will face Lincoln East. Both games will kick off at 7 p.m. and be covered right here on 93.7 The Ticket. This has been your Southeast Community College High School Minute. Learn more today at southeast.edu with locations in Lincoln, Beatrice, and Milford.
Landmark Implement, your local John Deere dealership, is searching for mechanics of all skill levels to grow with us. Landmark offers a competitive wage, full benefits package, along with paid time off within just 60 days of employment, as well as a 401k and a boot and clothing allowance. Interested in becoming a part of the Landmark difference? Apply now at landmarkimp.com/careers or contact Deanna 402-310-7561 or email careers at landmarkimp.com. That's landmarkimp.com. Landmark Implement is an equal opportunity employer.
Nebraska fans, it's almost time for college football season. Brokers Insurance Agency in Lincoln is a proud donor of Nebraska Athletics. Brokers Insurance Agency is located at 33rd and A Streets in the heart of Lincoln. At Brokers, they can help you with all your insurance needs. Let them worry about your insurance so you have more time to enjoy the college football season. Call one of their licensed agents today at 402-420-5353 or visit their website at brokersinsuranceNE.com. Go Big Red!
At first, I was really nervous and intimidated to buy a ring. I wasn't sure what I was getting into.
My experience at Starter Heyman was very easy. I felt like I walked out of Starter Heyman with the ring that was going to make her go wow and say yes.
I love my ring. It is so beautiful.
I absolutely love my ring. I get compliments on it all the time. I always tell them Starter Heyman.
Yeah, we would definitely recommend Starter Heyman.
Yeah, it was great.
We're definitely coming back.
Starter Heyman Jewelers, Lincoln and Grand Island. SauterHeyman.com.
Hey, it's Sean Callahan, and football season is here, and there is one place that has all the games plus great food and beer specials. Tanner's Bar and Grill at 30th and Yankee Hill. Whether it's Thursday night football, college football Saturdays, NFL Sundays, or Monday night football, there's a great view of the game from any seat with different food and drink specials every night. Try the Blue Ribbon Reuben Sandwich or the Prime Rib French Dip or any of their famous chicken wings. That's Tanner's Bar and Grill at 30th and Yankee Hill.
People first is more than a nice sentiment. At American Senior Benefits, it's the mission. If you're ready for a career where you can truly put your customers' needs ahead of everything else, this is for you. American Senior Benefits is one of the leading senior market insurance product distributors in the country, and they're looking for high-energy applicants with strong communication skills. Enjoy on-the-job training, a fun work environment, and unlimited income potential. Visit asbmidwest.com to learn more. American Senior Benefits.
People always ask, what are Jake and Sip like when they're off the air? Well, the answer probably won't surprise you.
Hey, Jake, your Honda's looking a little dirty.
Says the guy whose license plate is barely visible.
I mean, do you even care about that thing anymore?
It gets a little uncomfortable. Now that's when I jump in.
Hey, whoa, Mark, did you get a new car?
Nope, just took my car down to Nebraska Auto Detail. Joe and the staff made the outside and the inside look amazing. Maybe you guys need to go.
Okay, wise guy.
Settle down, Jake.
Book your appointment today at NebraskaAutoDetail.com.
Lose fat, build muscle, gain endurance. Whatever your goal, Farrell's Extreme Body Shaping can help you achieve it. Farrell's offers group fitness for all levels in a fun, welcoming environment. Their proven method combines kickboxing, cardio, and strength training to get you in the best shape of your life. You've heard all about their 10-week challenges, but you can join as a member anytime. Head to fxblincoln.com to learn more. Farrell's Extreme Body Shaping at 40th and Yankee Hill or just south of 78th and Pioneers.
Hi, Sean Callahan here for Copple Chevrolet GMC, and things are cooking here in Louisville. We are really hitting on all cylinders right now, and deals are off the charts. We've got a lot more new 2022 and 2023 Chevrolet and GMC inventory than we've had in a long time. So make sure you check us out online, or do even better, stop on in the store and let us show you one in person. Our pre-owned lot is plumb full, so take that short money-saving drive down 144th Street or check us out online at copplecars.com. You'll be glad you did.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, sponsored by Wingstop, on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Okay, so let me give some shout-outs, man. Kevin McGinnis in the building. Stacey A. Griffin, appreciate that. DJ King, he probably has something to say about that music. I hope you got something else reloaded, DJ Black Shirt. That's what we're going to call you,
DJ Black Shirt. Okay, I think of some.
Hey, he says, for the first time in a long time, we've been playing normal football. I think the Huskers are getting on to that and maybe a little better this week. See, getting better. Team play requires everyone to step up and finish the play. Make adjustments when needed.
DJ day by day.
Yeah, getting better and better.
Team can't be beat.
Won't be beat. Elva. See how I participate? Kevin McGinn says, but I still expect their attitude and grit to eventually win today. I do too. But when I was talking about getting paid, I'm just saying, let's just talk about, I'm going to go through some, like, Iowa Hawkeyes, okay? We'll go through what their assistant coach is making. I don't, I'm not even going to talk head coach because he's the interim coach. Perfect. Let's just talk assistants then. Okay? Phil Parker, defensive coordinator, 2022 salary, $1.3
million. Well worth
big,
it.
Big Ten West champions, DJ.
Last long, year, long since you want to say that, let me back up. Stop. Just hold up. Mute his mic, Bach. I don't want to hear it. I'm doing a point here, Terrell. 2021 salary, $1.1 million. I'm doing something here. I'm going somewhere. Brian Franz. You know that name. 2021 salary, $860. 2022, $900,000. Huh? Mr. Big Ten West champs.
He's not getting that on the open market.
And I understand why these guys are getting paid like that.
Wallace. I ain't got a problem with that. Everybody need to get paid like that, though.
Well, when you produce on the field and you win and you go to good bowl games, you know, why would I pay some coaches who haven't been to a bowl game in 5-6 years? I mean,
who are you talking about? Pay what coaches? Who are you talking about?
Just how we gave the raises out.
Who are you talking about? We ain't talking about the past, Mr. Black, sir.
Okay, so you're coming
about the now, sir.
I mean, what you gonna? I understand what you're saying. I already know where you're coming from, but okay, you know,
I'm done vetting. I'm here. Don't worry about it. You can hear me, right?
Yeah, we can still hear you.
That's okay. As long as you can still hear me loud and clear, I'll be right back. Have some difficulties. Just as far as I got a little excited.
I think he's gonna come out in a little red outfit.
Yeah, he's gonna pop up with a surprise.
Yeah, he'll surprise.
Wouldn't that be funny if I did that? I don't even like Little Red.
Hey, Little Red's the best one.
Nah, I don't like Little Red. I guess I do like punching on him. You know, if you could punch on Little Red, get some frustration out, that'd be good.
If we go strip to be one of the practice dummies, that's not
no, bad. He'd have to wear, like, you know, how those boxers be having those big pads on.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He'd have to be a strong dude to be up in that thing, though. So let me finish I was on my text grind, and then I got something else to ask you guys. Might have Sheldon Jackson a little bit better later. Okay, so Randy says this. He has shown he can run. Not like 2 a.m., but it's about getting positive yards. If there's nothing after your second and third progression, run for 3 to 4 yards.
And that's more yards than just sitting back there taking a 5-yard sack, you know, or throwing, you know, we just need to get rid of the ball faster or just tuck it and go.
It's such a delicate balance to tell them, though, because, I mean, there's certain plays with Adrian Martinez, there were fans that were upset that he was tucking it and go too early, like sit in the pocket, try to look for something downfield. And that's what Casey generally does, is still try to make the play work with his arm. Occasionally he'll run and he'll slide, but usually it's not too impactful. But obviously it's better than a sack, and credit to him. Because a lot of credit should go to him for just having one sack last week. We were all surprised by that because the offensive line the way that they played was to allow more than that, but he only had one
that
sack.
That was it. I thought now, he had 3-4.
Yeah, the pressure did cause at least one of his interceptions. So, you know, even the sack is better than an interception. So there's still, you know, some problems that he's got to go along that line. It's just, it's such a delicate balance to say on this play or that play, you should do this or that. You know, I like the fact that he kind of sticks in the pocket and tries to make something work downfield too.
Listen, Seneca is the home of the Seneca High School Indians. I think I said that. Jeff Seal is the head wrestling coach there. Jeff was an All-American wrestler at the University of Nebraska, Omaha.
There we go.
Joe B. says, Husker haters are just the kind of people that hate to hate. Nothing positive comes from negative comments. John says, good morning, Rashawn, the black shirt, and Bach. Who do you want to see get significant playing time? I want to see Tommy Hill. I want to see if he can run by a cornerback. He could open things up for Trey. Can you hear me? Is this thing on? John. Okay, he was speaking to you guys, too. I'm going to let you have it. Mm-hmm. No?
You have an idea yet, Blackshirt? I mean, I'm interested in Tommy Hill. I think that that's an interesting one. Obviously, he was pretty good in high school as a wide receiver. To be able to do it at the college at the Big Ten level, with a quick transition. I mean, we'll see, but we know he's one of the better athletes on the team. They still have him, as you pointed out, Terrell, earlier in the week at kick returner. You believe that he could do some stuff in space if you have him there. So, you know, that's a really good one. There's a lot of guys that are kind of lost on the depth chart, I guess, to a degree, that people want to see out there, but I'm not lingering behind thinking that they're leaving somebody on the bench that really can make a difference. I'm really interested to see, you know, just kind of how this defensive secondary, if it can continue to be a strength. 3 interceptions last week, young corner kind of got picked on. Is he going to step his game back up? That's what I'm most intrigued by with this Purdue matchup.
Yeah. And, my thing with it is that we got Quinn Newsome is, you know, he's not 100% this week. You know, he's got a bad groin injury, so we don't know his status. So, my thought would be just to keep him on defensive side for a minute, just to let, you know, because if Quentin can't go, then, you know, we don't know how good our number 2 guy is. We do know he has to play, but do we know, can he step up and help with the guy from Purdue this year? And that's a pretty good receiver they got.
Oh, yeah.
So at the same time, you know, we might need to keep him on the defensive side of the ball till we get the DB side figured out and healthy. So, you know, that's my take on it.
All right. Listen, we're going to throw it to break after I read this. Throw it straight to break. 9099 says this. Go Big Red from Wichita, Kansas. This game will set the tone for the rest of the season. Establish a run game. Protect Casey. Play blend. Don't break. Play bend. Don't break defense. Enforce a turnover. Expect to win. We are Nebraska. Go Big, you know what, Red. Find a way to win. Be right back.
This is Lincoln's home for sports talk on the FM dial. Also online at theticketfm.com.
On the internet.
KNTK FM Firth, 93.7 The Ticket.
Mary Ellen's Food for the Soul. It's soul food right here in Lincoln. Ribs, wings, catfish, coleslaw, cornbread, grits. I mean, I'd say it's food like your grandma used to make, but my grandma never made food like that. If you haven't already, you've got to give it a try. Check out their location across from South Point at 27th and Pine Lake, or find their food truck at events all over town, or visit them online at maryellens.com to see the full menu. Mary Ellen's Food for the Soul. Let them fix you a plate.
Problem gambling affects millions of Americans daily, of all ages and walks of life. If you or a loved one is struggling with addiction, contact Choices Treatment Center's 24-hour helpline at 402-476-2300. That's 402-476-2300.
People always ask, what are Jake and Sip like when they're off the air? Well, the answer probably won't surprise you.
Hey, Jake, your Honda's looking a little dirty.
Says the guy whose license plate is barely visible.
I mean, do you even care about that thing anymore?
It gets a little uncomfortable. Now that's when I jump in.
Hey, whoa, Mark, did you get a new car?
Nope, just took my car down to Nebraska Auto Detail. Joe and the staff made the outside and the inside look amazing. Maybe you guys need to go.
Okay, wise guy.
Settle down, Jake.
Book your appointment today at NebraskaAutoDetail.com.
People first is more than a nice sentiment. At American Senior Benefits, it's the mission. If you're ready for a career where you can truly put your customers' needs ahead of everything else, this is for you. American Senior Benefits is one of the leading senior market insurance product distributors in the country, and they're looking for high-energy applicants with strong communication skills. Enjoy on-the-job training, a fun work environment, and unlimited income potential. Visit ASBMidwest.com to learn more. American Senior Benefits.
Get an immediate look back at the game from the people who know it best. It's the Tanner's Postgame Show and the Final Word live from Tanner's Bar and Grill at 30th and Yankee Hill. Hear from former players and national champions like Jay Foreman, Rashawn Jackson, and Aaron Davis and see what they saw in that day's game. It's the Tanner's Postgame Show and the Final Word live and in person, home or away at Tanner's Bar and Grill, brought to you by Bauer Infrastructure. Only here on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Wow, did you ever save me money on my car?
Yes, that's why our customers keep coming back.
How do you do it, friendly car dealer question mark?
We simply have low overhead and high trade-in values. The next line's yours.
Oh.
Ready for something better? Mullen Motors is a no-hassle, no-pressure dealership with financing available. Check out the inventory at MikeMullenMotors.com.
No taglines, just quality vehicles. Mullen Motors.
In today's day and age, people are trying to do more and more projects by themselves. That might be better on the wallet, but it can also lead to painful sounds like this.
Ah! Ah! Ow!
Poor guy, trying to do wiring all by himself. Let's have another listen.
Ah! Ah!
It's just not worth it. Don't hurt yourself or make things worse than they are already. For any of your electric needs, call Joe at Ambition Electric today at 402-217-3415 or go to ambitionelectric.com.
Working at Continental in Lincoln isn't a job, it's a career. And right now they've raised wages again and they're hiring for production operators at $22.58 per hour. And other select jobs are starting at $24.28 per hour, with wages growing up to $30.30 per hour. Continental also has salaried jobs available and great benefits, plus medical and prescription costs at very low premiums. Dental, vision, and life insurance are offered at no premium cost to the associates. To learn more or to apply, go to continental-jobs.com with keyword Lincoln. Come work at Continental today.
John Henry's Plumbing.
When it comes to your home or business, we know you have options, and that's why John Henry's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning gives you just that. Options. We have plumbing, heating, and cooling memberships to serve all of your residential and commercial needs. We want to ensure you, your family, and your business are safe. Visit our website, jhlincoln.com, to find out more or call us at
435-5555. John Henry's Plumbing. Heating and air.
What happens when students come to school every day on time and ready to learn? They improve academically, become more responsible, manage their time well, and learn the value of education. Whether your child is starting preschool or preparing to graduate, family support and a great attitude towards education is important. Help your child come to school every day ready to learn. Make this the best school year yet.
Sponsored by the Nebraska State Education Association, aired by the Nebraska Broadcasters Association and this station.
This is 93.7 The Ticket.
Look at me short. Look at me short. I'm the captain now.
Three-time national champion, Rashawn Jackson.
I got a bunch all alone is Rashawn Jackson. And Rashawn, he'll get it to the 24-yard line.
Coming at you live from the Koppel Chevrolet GMC studios in the heart of Lincoln, America. On air and online at theticketfm.com. Presented by Wingstop. Here he is, Rashawn Jackson.
Ah, yeah!
All right. Yeah, we're gonna go. Look, we're gonna be like AD them with three guys here singing slow music. Now this ain't even slow music though, but you know.
Okay, so let's do this real quick. Shout out to all my Twitter handlers too. Everybody on Twitter, everybody that's following me on Twitter, shout out to you guys. Appreciate it. Keep it coming. Thanks for the love, all that good stuff. How about this one? Dan Snyder has dirt on the NFL. Goodell and the owners. mess with me if you want to. But give us some background on that.
Yeah, well, obviously, Snyder's been in his own troubles. Obviously, they had to change the name, but even more than that, just basically a lack of institutional control, bad things going on behind the scenes. So it's interesting. It seems like there's could be a movement. It hasn't quite started, but it feels like it's right there to push Dan Snyder out as an NFL owner. And so I guess he's blackmailing them. He hired a private investigator. Now he's got enough dirt, he thinks, on the NFL and then a lot of the people out there maybe to prevent that sort of thing from going down, which, you know, it's hard to know whether that's true or not, but I'm sure. You know, I'm sure he's got a thing or two.
Yeah, but you said blackmail, though. I mean, you know, they meet all the time. They have owners meetings. The owner, you think the owners are meeting with? They're meeting with the league. How they're going to do things. The refs are there. They have the refs association. You know what I mean? I mean, I don't know how much he had to dig, but if he dug, it's even worse. So what do? Do you leave him alone or you let him bogart the league? Or do you say I'm ready for the fight?
I don't know. I mean, it depends. Again, we don't know what these, what are the skeletons in the closet for the NFL for some of these owners? Is it worth taking the fight? Or, I mean, if you're clean, then say, you know, call his bluff, you know, or if he's got something, you know, minor on you, call his bluff. But, you know, it's up to
he's saying that he's willing to take the suicide bomb and set it off on everybody.
Yeah.
That's what he's saying. He'd rather tell everything and they had a whole league go down if they're going to try to run him out. At least that's what I feel, in my opinion, he's saying. I could be wrong.
Well, he's got several things on several owners of the NFL and they can't bloop with me. I guess he's ready to go to war.
Ooh, that's what I'm saying.
What you gonna do
in that situation? They didn't already both. The Cleveland Indians?
They switched to the Guardians, the baseball team.
Is it still the Kansas City Chiefs?
It is still the Kansas City Chiefs.
Kansas City haven't switched yet, though, huh?
No.
Well, that's the same thing, isn't it?
Maybe in a few years it might happen, but yeah.
Can you tell me why it's a problem being a Cleveland Indian?
It has to do something with the Indian culture and you know how stuff was back in the early whatever years it was, but you know it goes all the way back that and with it's a big it's just I don't know, man. It's just crazy.
Well, I think too the problem with the Indians and the Redskins who had to change is that it was kind of the Redskins is pretty on the nose. I mean, you know, you're just calling out somebody up by their skin color. So that one was kind of problematic for a long time. But for the Indians, they had that kind of character too of a red Indian, which red was one of their colors. But I think that very direct skin color type of tone type of correlation is why those teams got specifically targeted more so than maybe the Chiefs or Seminoles or whatever.
What about Cleveland? What's their deal? Cleveland what?
They're the Indians.
They're the Guardians now.
The football team.
The Browns.
The Browns.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to figure this thing out, man. What's going on? You know what I mean? They changing names and anyway. Okay. That's a hot topic moment. I'm sorry. We're not on hot topics, are we? Can we call Sheldon Jackson?
Tuesdays,
yeah, let's we can try go. To call Sheldon Jackson.
All right, let me. All right, you guys talk.
You can get Sheldon on. Let me ask you a question, Terrell. Who's the number one team in the lane?
UGA.
What? That's why you had that shirt on, huh?
Yeah, we I'm not gonna say we, but my home state.
You go ahead and say we. It's okay.
My home state. You know,
you're part of that too.
Defending national champions. They reclaimed the number one spot. After Alabama fell two spots, so it moved Ohio State up to number two, and I don't know if Georgia has a powerful offense than most like the Ohio States do this year, but they have a great defense. So we're gonna let it play out for the rest of the year and just see how the top four goes. You know, right now it's Georgia, Alabama, Ohio State.
No, no.
Georgia, Ohio State, Alabama, and is it Michigan? Clemson. I don't think Clemson is a great team though. I think they're beatable. So we have to just see because they done had several close games this year.
When does Michigan play Ohio State?
Oh, that's towards the end of the season.
Oh, okay.
So, but we have Michigan and Ohio State this week. So, I mean, Penn State. I don't know where they're playing at, but you know, I would like to see them go to Penn State and play in that whiteout. You know, I think that was very cool the last time they did it.
Yeah, number six is Tennessee on the rise. Remember the Tennessee fan that called in?
Yeah,
got to be feeling a certain type of way.
Yeah, and they got right before the season. They play Alabama this weekend, so that's going to be a great game.
Who you taking?
It depends. It depends if the quarterback is playing or not.
Yeah, Bryce Young.
Yeah, if Bryce Young is not playing, I'll go with Tennessee because they struggled last week. Right now, I'm leaning at Tennessee.
But.
Like I said, usually if you want to be right in your predictions, pick Alabama 12 times a year. They might let you down once.
But I think it's that one, though.
This could be. I could definitely see it. Tennessee's on the rise.
Take the odds.
But if Hendon Hooker leads that victory for the Vols, I think you've got a new Heisman favorite.
Yeah.
Number seven, USC.
Yeah. Them and UCLA.
No.
Yep, both undefeated.
Yeah. But number eight, Okie State.
Yeah. You got to keep a Big 12 team in there.
Well, yeah. I mean, they're down in the totem pole. Number nine, Ole Miss.
Well, yeah, great team till they play Alabama. So, you know, they still got to play Mississippi State, which is, I think, undefeated too. So, we'll have to wait and see.
Number 10, Penn State.
Plays Michigan in this week.
That's at Michigan.
That's at Michigan, by the
way. That's a big game. That's probably one of the biggest games of the week.
Yeah, Big Noon.
Oh, Big Noon. I'll be watching that one.
Ooh, me too. We got a lot of games to watch, man. That'd be a heck of a weekend coming up, huh?
Oh, yeah. There's a lot of, like, top 25 battles between two teams. I think there's five games.
This might be upset Saturday.
Who's good? You're saying Tennessee is an upset, right? Are you counting that in your upset?
Yeah, that's part of an upset.
Who else?
If I picked Alabama.
You got less than 24 hours.
Who else playing? Mississippi State. Who else playing, Bob?
Yeah, Mississippi State's playing Kentucky. That's number 16, Mississippi State at 22, Kentucky.
So I'm going to take Mississippi State on that. I'm going to wait, though. So,
you got Utah, number 20, could potentially upset number 7, USC.
0563 says this. Sorry to buddy in, and then you guys get back. He said, it's the name. They are Native American and not Indian. Indians are from India. Yeah. Okay, give me some more.
Some of the better games this week. I'm really interested in this is the Big Ten West. Obviously, the only one ranked team is Illinois at number 24. They'll host Minnesota, who was ranked a couple weeks ago. I think that could be the best two teams in the Big Ten West. Of course, outside Nebraska, Purdue, which are playing.
Who you like?
I think that, I mean, that they're built identically. These are the Big Ten West blueprint type of teams. Great defenses, big offensive lines, running games. We'll see if Mo Ibrahim, the running back for Minnesota, I think he'll be back this week against Chase Brown, two of the better running backs in the league and the nation. I'm probably leaning toward, I guess I see it pretty even. So I guess I lean toward the home team in Illinois.
Yeah. I would rather, Minnesota win so they could knock Illinois down to 2-2 in the Big Ten. So, you know, that gives us a chance, you know, if we don't have a great game that we can still go beat Minnesota and Illinois and just take the front runner thing in it. So, you know, it's a lot of scenarios in this Big Ten West right here. So, you know, I'm just hoping Minnesota probably can knock them off.
As long as we win out, I don't care who win that game. As long as we keep winning. Because at some point, we got to play them.
Yeah, both of them.
Well, so this is this right here for us, for me as a coach. I'm looking at this game as a game that I can really get a lot of what these teams are going to do when we take them on.
Do we play Iowa here this year?
No, on the road.
It seems like we go to Iowa every year.
We just forget the games here.
We do go to Purdue almost every year. I think this is the third out of 4 years that we're going to Purdue.
Remember Smothers? Smothers was the quarterback last year at home.
For Iowa, yeah.
No, for us.
Well, no, yeah.
In the Iowa game.
Oh, yeah. No, that's Black Friday. I don't watch football on Black Friday.
What do you mean?
What do you mean?
It's Nebraska, Iowa every year.
I'm in the line. I'm trying to get me a TV. I'm trying to get something great.
Bryce says, Captain, what's good? I don't know, man. A little bit of this, a little bit of that. Jesse says, the Indians and the Redskins were bad teams and weren't representing well. They fired them. Quentin says, Chiefs have the backing of local tribes. The term Chiefs is considered noble. Thomas and Liga, that's funny. I ain't reading it, though. South Dakota State versus North Dakota State. Who we like?
I have to look a little bit more into that one. I'll admit that's a little off my radar.
Okay, cool. I thought the text line asked about that. Sanderson says Mississippi State lost one game to LSU.
Ugh. Yeah, they're not undefeated, but they're ranked.
They're nine.
Mississippi State?
Ole Miss.
Ole Miss. Mississippi State. No.
Mike Leach, the Pirates, got them going. Mississippi State.
Terrell, did you get any offers to play in the SEC?
Yeah, Florida out of high school.
Really?
Yeah. I visited Auburn, Georgia, Florida.
What position you played in high school again?
I played more like a DN outside linebacker.
Hmm.
More like if I didn't have a tight end on my side, I was more of a linebacker. But if I had a tight end on my side, I'm more like a defensive end.
You up on him?
Yeah.
You can put your hands on him?
Yeah.
You're not going to let him free release?
Nah.
Well, I can tell you right now, 87 is going to try to free release. And he's big.
You think
you could have handled him? He's like 6'7".
VJ, that's the name of the game, VJ. Never back down from a challenge, you know? Some things ain't a challenge. He got to worry about me. Sometimes I don't have to worry about him.
Terrell, if you knew you were going against a pretty good person, because you had some good tight ends, you know. Colorado had some good tight ends that played in the league for a long time. Or were you not covering the tight end? That wasn't your
job. That was more of a Jay and Jamel job, you know.
Yeah, that's why you never came over in one-on-one blocks, huh?
Yeah, because I didn't really have to deal with a tight end like that. So, you know, but basically that was the Sam job, because the Sam lines up on the strong side of the football all the time. And that's just how it goes with that.
Yeah, they protected you. they knew Coach Osborne knew, like, yeah, don't let Terrell go over there. That ain't, because coaches, you know what I'm saying? It would have been too many scraps over there if you'd have came.
Yeah, I would hate to get y'all upset.
I'm being nice, Terrell. I'm being nice.
Being nice to you, dude.
John C. says, what's your favorite superhero, VJ? Good shows, guys. In real life, my grandpa. In real superhero life, it's the only one and only Superman.
No, man. Come on, get out of here. You supposed to say the Brown Hornet. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, man. I mean, I love the Brown Hornet, but if I had a opportunity to be Superman or the Brown Hornet, give me Superman.
I say the Hulk. That was one of my favorite shows.
The Hulk?
You know, with Bruce, you know, that on David Banner.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not talking about the cartoon. I'm talking about the real life.
Yeah.
Hulk, when they played that back in the days. And I'm a, you know, I'm a TV guy. So I used to watch TJ Hooker, the Fall Guy. Clint, you know, I used to watch all them shows that.
Here's a question: how come when the Hulk gets bigger, his pants get bigger too?
Well, they rip up. You see them at the
they
end.
They rip up a little bit. Pretty big chance.
He's damn near butt naked, man.
Well, I know.
When he wakes up. How you think that guy feels?
Hey, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
He's got other problems going on.
Wait, hey guys, you got a point there, Bot, because you can't go from a 32 waist to a 70 and your pants still be on you.
Yeah. You got some really elastic pants or something you're walking around with all day.
And most of the time, he had some jeans on.
Yeah. Well, maybe the Hulk was just big up top and little at bottom. You know what I'm saying?
It was Lou Ferrigno. Yeah. It was Lou Ferrigno.
Yeah, he wasn't that big.
He was that big. They had the one guy come in, and then Lou Ferrigno, well, that's how they did it.
Yeah.
That is funny, though. You got to admit, that's pretty funny. Did we get Sheldon or no?
No, we need you to text his number. I don't think we have it here.
Oh, man. Y'all. What's your favorite superhero, Bob?
Oh, Batman, by far. I'm a huge Batman guy, more for the villains. I think he's got the best lineup of villains than anything. Also, Bruce Wayne.
Villain. What Batman villain would you be?
Would I be?
Yeah.
Well.
Say it.
Yeah, maybe probably Two-Face. I mean, he's got some political power. He's always flipping that card around. Yeah, Harvey Dent.
Oh, Harvey Dent. Look at you, Harvey.
He doesn't like overwhelm you with his strength. I don't think I can quite do that. Yeah.
I thought you would have said you probably like somebody like Johnny Quest. Huh?
No, we said villain. Villain. No,
like a superhero.
Captain Planet. I believe in keeping this planet.
You talking about. You think he had.
Uh-oh. Oh, there we lost the captain. Oh, we're losing everybody.
Uh-oh. Yeah. What happened?
I don't know. We lost. You know what? We will fix this up. We'll go to break. We can still hear Terrell. We can't hear VJ, but we got some technical difficulties. That's okay. We'll go to break. We'll figure it out, and we might have Sheldon Jackson when we return. It's coming up next year on The Captain.
Life-changing research doesn't just take place in outer space. It's also happening right here in Nebraska, and you could play a key role. Solarion, one of the world's leading clinical research organizations, needs healthy adults who are 19 years old and older for a research opportunity. If you qualify, you could earn up to $500 a day for time and travel. Overnight stays may be required. To learn more, call Solarion at 866-213-2965 or visit helpresearch.com/...
What does continuing education mean to you? At Southeast Community College, it means helping you advance. Whether that's a fundamental course in accounting or marketing to help your business, or helping you become a better leader, SCC can help you take the next step. Financial assistance is available too. Learn more about our business development classes at southeast.edu/continuing education. SCC, your path to personal and professional development.
John Henry's Plumbing. Heating
and air. When it comes to your home or business, we know you have options, and that's why John Henry's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning gives you just that. Options. We have plumbing, heating, and cooling memberships to serve all of your residential and commercial needs. We want to ensure you, your family, and your business are safe. Visit our website, jhlincoln.com, to find out more or call us at
435-5555. John Henry's Plumbing. Heating and air.
The Lincoln Chamber of Commerce is excited to showcase and celebrate our local businesses. Make plans to attend this year's Lincoln Expo on Wednesday, October 19th from 10 a.m. until 3 p.m. at Pinnacle Bank Arena. Be sure to take time to network and check out the interactive booths from area businesses. Lincoln's Craft Beer Tour returns, plus great door prizes and a free Lincoln t-shirt just for you while supplies last. Admission is free, so make sure to stop by PBA on October 19th. Shop local at the 2022 Lincoln Expo.
Start your Sundays off right with Jeff and Nicole Essink on Fitness Fanatics. Jeff and Nicole discuss health and wellness, how to achieve fitness goals, and more through the life of gym owners and gym goers. It's Fitness Fanatics from 9 to 11 a.m. on Sundays on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
This is Dan Friedman. Between 2010 and 2019, distracted driving caused more than 40,000 car crashes in Nebraska, resulting in over 14,000 severe injuries and deaths. Please keep your eyes on the road. If you have a smartphone, put it away while you're behind the wheel. It will help keep our community safe and secure. This message is brought to you by Friedman Law Offices, helping injured people. It's what we do. It's all we do. Find us at friedmanlaw.com today.
When you were a kid, clubs were cool. Robotics club, or space club, and stuff like that. But what do adults get? Book clubs and quilting clubs? Nah, forget that. How about a margarita club? Get to Upside Bar and Lounge and join the best club in town. 10 flavors of margarita, like Maui Wowie, Burnt Pineapple, and Mango Tango. Try all 10 of them and receive your own souvenir margarita glass. Make it your new Monday night tradition. $4 margaritas and $4 taco baskets. Grab the crew and head on over Monday nights or any night. Upside Bar and Lounge at 29th and Pine Lake.
It's tailgate season. Why would you bounce around from place to place for all your beverage needs when you could have it all in one place? Wine, Beer, and Spirits has everything for your parties with their three locations in Lincoln, Grand Island, and Omaha. It's the largest liquor store in the state, and here's the best part. You can get a drink from their bar and walk around with it as you shop for all your tailgate necessities. Locally owned and operated, it's Wine, Beer, and Spirits on North 27th Street in Lincoln.
93.7 The Ticket, Fox KFXL Weather. Brought to you by Bryant Air Conditioning, Heating, Electrical, and Plumbing.
Windy conditions will be in place yet again today as northwest winds could gust over 40. A red flag warning will be in effect this afternoon due to critical fire danger as we see an afternoon high of around 61. A few passing clouds tonight with a low of 40. It will be windy again tomorrow but slightly warmer with a high of 71. I'm meteorologist Tim Wright for 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
People first is more than a nice sentiment. At American Senior Benefits, it's the mission. If you're ready for a career where you can truly put your customers' needs ahead of everything else, this is for you. American Senior Benefits is one of the leading senior market insurance product distributors in the country, and they're looking for high-energy applicants with strong communication skills. Enjoy on-the-job training, a fun work environment, and unlimited income potential. Visit ASBMidwest.com to learn more. American Senior Benefits.
Hey, this is Ernest Hausman. As a linebacker from Nebraska, I know how important it is to have a strong defense and a great playbook. If you are looking for a solid team to have your back, check out my friends at Burke Brown Law. Burke and Jackson will work with you to create an individualized strategy to bolster your defense.
Hi, this is Burke. Give us a call at 402-606-1441. With locations in Lincoln and Columbus, we're ready to tackle your needs. Find us online at burkebrownlaw.com.
This message is for Karina, our mom who finished her high school diploma at age 28. Hi, Mom. It's Amethyst and Nicholas.
Congratulations on getting your diploma.
You worked so hard and have taught us so much.
We love you.
When you graduate, they graduate. Finish your high school diploma for you and for them. Visit finishyourdiploma.org to find free and supportive adult education centers near you. Brought to you by the Dollar General Literacy Foundation and the Ad Council.
Busted. Back with Vershawn Jackson, sponsored by Wingstop, on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
Okay, so by the way, North Dakota State is number one in FCS.
Okay.
South Dakota State is number two in FCS.
So wow.
It's a big, big game today. It's a
big FCS battle. Yeah. Yes.
That's huge.
The Battle of the Dakotas. Do you guys think that North Dakota and South Dakota should eventually merge into one giant Dakota?
No.
No.
You mess up the rivalry. This is a rivalry game.
Yeah, I'm just saying as a state, though. I mean, you can keep the schools.
And be what? Dakota?
Just be Dakota, yeah.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Yeah.
That's why you never see Bruce Banner walking around in skinny jeans, black shirt.
He's got a big, wear big baggy pants.
Hey, Bryce asked this, which actor is your favorite Batman, Bach?
Ooh. Was it Christian Bale? Is that his name? I think he's pretty good.
John C.
I'm an overwhelming one.
John C. says Batman is not a superhero, Bach, just a rich man.
Hey, all the more reason to like him. I think I like Bruce Wayne more than Batman, but you know, I'll just take whatever comes.
What when I shredded, who is TJ? Oh man, this is what 2895 says. VJ share what it felt like when you shredded TJ. Oh my goodness, man. That was probably my best game my senior year. And it wasn't fair. TJ was a stat game. You know what I mean? And listen, when I tell you, I could have broke the record with 7 touchdowns, but you know, I think I had 5 or 6, something like that. 5 running, and then I had an interception for a touchdown too. So I got into, you know, that was pretty big for me for a black shirt. Felt pretty good about that. Great game for the big.
Who's TJ?
Huh?
Who's TJ?
Thomas Jefferson High School.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they were the, we call it stat game because you knew it was going to be a big time stat game. They were not very good. No. They were the Pacifics. Terrell, they were Pacific. I don't know. Did you ever play against Pacific?
Yeah, we made Pacific disbando after that year we played. They didn't play no more that year.
I think you're right.
I mean, that was it for them after that year.
They shut down the program.
Yeah.
They shut the program down. You're
done. We didn't even beat them that bad. I think we beat like 39-0.
Nah.
Yeah.
What year? 95?
Yeah. We didn't beat them that bad.
Nah. I don't never remember Pacific being less than 50 something to nothing. Those were nothing games. So that means the third stream would get in and still shut them down. Augie says, ask the black shirt if he can sing the Fall Guy theme song.
Cause I'm the only stunt man that makes Eastwood look so fine. Ding, 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 ding. I used to love the Fall Guy. TJ Hooker.
That's what it is? All right.
That's the Fall Guy.
Hey, Bach, you have to go look that up to get a different laugh, a delayed laugh. What you looking up? And thank you for Captain for signing my pendant. No problem. Much appreciated. Ray 10-2 says, Bach, came to work. No, he didn't. They should combine the Dakotas to make a big Dakota.
So we hung 70% 40.
Our victory over Pacific was 70-21 in 90, and that was 1994, and then 95, 49-7.
Yeah, 49-7. So
told you. I mean, it was a bombing. That was the last, how many years you just read? That was what year?
Just 2 years, 94 and 95.
Perfect. 93, it was a shellacking. I don't think we played them again. That was it, right?
Yeah, I think it was.
Oh man, I got my first taste of licks against an opponent against guess who?
Pacific.
That's right.
I had 2 sacks against. I think I had a sack against them. Yeah, I had a quarterback.
Yeah, this was 1994 though. Remember, I was still on scout team, and I actually got in the game. I was probably 120 out of 125. And I got in the game. AD played in that game.
Did he fall down and get his uniform?
I think AD had a catch in that game.
Yeah?
Yeah.
AD.
We got in the game, man. Listen, we would get in the game and we'd be so happy that, you know, we could lay a licking on somebody else instead of getting a licking laid on us. This is true. The black shirts were relentless to victory. They had no quit, none of them. The backups knew if they went into the game and they sloughed off, guess what's going to happen? Somebody on that black shirt, don't smack them around. Tell them, man, you better get it together. Christian Bell sounded like he was constipated throughout the trilogy.
That's fair enough. I thought he played a good Bruce Wayne, though. Like I said, maybe not the best Batman.
Who is Miles Morales? Who is that? Spider-Man and Miles Morales was the best superheroes. Who's that? We know?
I'll look that one up. I don't know.
Dave Braskin says, Northern North Dakota State Tech versus Southern South Dakota State Tech. Just merge them into the Dakota State Tech.
Yes. We're giant Dakota.
I don't know about that one, buddy. John C. says, Michael Keaton is the best Batman.
He is. Best one.
I am Batman. That's what y'all say?
Yeah.
Who was the first Batman?
Adam West. Adam West was a great one.
Is that black and white?
But who's the second Batman?
Well, the Val Kilmer has been Batman.
Val Kilmer, then Michael Keaton.
Michael Keaton. George Clooney was an awful Batman. That didn't work out.
Yeah.
Robert Pattinson's the latest Batman. Ben Affleck was the Batman in Batman vs. Superman.
Who's the Batman that had to go up to the, like, he had to go up in the mountains? Who's that one? Which one is he?
Val. No, that's the,
remember he had to go in the mountains and then they, you know,
he came back.
Yeah,
that's after they killed.
That's Christian Bale. I think,
commissioner.
Yeah, I like him. You're right. That's the best one. Mr. Leonard 75 says, "You guys hung 70 on Pacific." Think about that, Box. 70 points. We're talking track meet.
Yeah. Poor Pacific. It's funny because I haven't heard about their college until I started hanging out with you guys, the mid '90s Husker guys. Now I hear about Pacific a lot more these days.
Eric says, lay off an AD for Shine. LOL. Tyler, quick question. Why'd I get canceled? Tyler got canceled?
Maybe. I don't know.
Who canceled Tyler? Did I canceled you, Tyler? Come on. Oh, I was going to say your best joker, man. Yeah. Why'd you get canceled? Let me see what you're talking about. All right, this is what Tyler says. Let me read Tyler's. Tyler, you're part of the clan. You're part of the captain's people. I get why you want him paid, but he's getting paid while being interviewed for the job. Not a bad gig. Listen, I can go to probably, if there's 16 teams in the Big Ten, I can go to at least 10 of them that the coordinators are making more than Mickey. I'm done with that. Best joker. Come on.
I'm Terrell? Not great with actors' names. That's why I'm looking it up here.
Heath Ledger. Okay.
Heath Ledger, yeah. Although Jack Nicholson was really good.
Thank you. Are you kidding me right now?
Yeah.
The great Jack Nicholson probably was the best joker. Or this guy from last time. He was kind of real. He was kind of.
Yeah, like, Joaquin Phoenix.
Hate to run up on that dude.
Yeah, he's kind of great.
Mike Morales is an African-American Spider-Man who's the main character in Spider-Man Into the Spideyverse.
Okay. Yeah, I didn't get into all the multi-Spider-Man guys yet.
He's still Spider-Man when he puts this deal on his Spider-Man. He said, I would like to see the Dakota school jump into the Big 12. Your thoughts?
No.
Why?
Why?
Well, it'll take away from the teams up this way that they play. But I think for the Dakotas, that's a good thing. Nobody probably want to go up to there and play.
Go to the Mountain West.
They might have to make the FBS jump before you do the Power 5 jump. But they have beaten several Big 12 schools over the years. I don't know if you can do that consistently.
Well, you said it. You got to go to FBS first. You can't just go foo foo. Then I don't think that'd be a good idea at that point. 8729. The best superhero is Wolverine.
Oh, X-Men. Yeah, he's pretty good.
That's my number two guy. I'm a Wolverine fan.
I like Cyclops if we're talking X-Men, I think. Or Gambit, the guy that throws cards at people. Doesn't seem to help too much, but
you kind of look like Gambit.
Yeah, I just got to learn some card tricks.
Tyler, we know you're not in there. We know you're not a part of the bland. Just stop it. We know it. That was a misspeak by the captain. I can do that sometimes. I'm 47 years old. Give me a break.
Yeah.
50 is right around the corner.
Tyler, I had to make sure, hey, I'm not part of that.
Mr. Limited 75 says Tyler probably got brought by Rico. There you go.
Could be.
Rico got you. You got hit by Rico. Dave Braska, Idaho State was the worst football team to ever play in Lincoln.
That was pretty ugly.
What was the score?
I think 70. They may even top your 70. I think it was 77. I'll have to go back and look. This is like 2013 or something.
So let me ask you a question. If that's so, you know what I'm saying? Like us hanging 70 points on bad teams and bad organizations. So what does that say about Nebraska hanging 70-something on Oklahoma? In Oklahoma.
That was a bad team, though, too, VJ. That was a real bad team.
It was Oklahoma, sir.
They wasn't disciplined at all, you know.
I don't care. They was big, and there was some big dudes, man.
They didn't have nothing. I mean, they couldn't even move the ball.
That just goes to show you it ain't the bigger they are. You know what I'm saying?
That's when they had them running backs.
There you go.
But some of those, like Idaho State, it was like they just didn't have the size. There's just didn't belong in the same field. You have those games every once in a while.
Eric said, probably don't name it Captain's Clan.
No.
Come on. That wouldn't be a good deal.
There are other clans, but.
Yeah, well, they got all kind of, they got X. What's the music thing? We don't get mad at that. You know what I'm saying? Whatever. Let's go to Mike Morales' Black Spider-Man animated. Blah, blah, got that. Curtis and Lincoln 8-4 says, wait till they get a load of May. Jack. I got it. 9121 said the best superhero is Deadpool. Really? No. Deadpool just came about.
God, yeah. I'm not a fan of that movie.
You really got to like comedy. I mean, that's less superhero. Yeah,
that's gore comedy, ain't it?
Yeah.
Like, I want to see people's necks getting cut off and then they form back on again. He'd be
what about the one Will Smith played? What was his name?
That drunk one, Hancock? Hancock.
You would Hancock. Say that, Terrell Farley. Hancock, really?
He's like stumbling all over the place. All
really?
The time.
Really? Really, Terrell? Hancock.
Yeah, that's an outside the box idea.
Oh my goodness. I don't know. They say Deadpool, Crowbanks, Deadpool. What about Deadpool? VJ Chase B says. Followed by Underdog, whoever that DC Dell says. Who the heck is Underdog?
Underdog. That's a dog, ain't
that's
it?
A dog, I think.
Yeah.
Who is he? He just some type of underdog, like a.
He's like an old cartoon, like tiny dog with a cape. I don't know what he actually did.
I don't remember that.
That's like Scrappy Doo size.
Yeah,
he's like one little guy.
Yeah,
I remember Mighty Mouse.
Yeah.
Here I come to save the day.
What was the
Mighty Mouse is on the way.
Who was the other little rat? Arriba, arriba, arriba. What was that one called? The little mouse.
Speedy Gonzalez.
Oh, yeah. Speedy Gonzalez. Yeah. That's right.
Y'all stop playing with me, man. Y'all trying to take me back. You know what they need to do? They need to bring those games back, right? Can you guys see
me? Yeah, kids should be watching those, maybe.
Can you see me?
Yeah, we can see you.
Can you? I can't see you. Let me see you. Nah. Throw it to break, Terrell. What just happened? It just
give me a beat, Bach. What is this?
Okay? No, that's a good beat. Play that, Bach. Let get that to him. He'll like it later.
All right.
Play it, Bach. Play it.
Turn it up, Bach.
Matter of fact, Bach, you got to start it over. Start it over for him. Give him run at it. Let's give the black shirt a real run at it. Start it over.
Oh, I know who this is. It's Boosie.
Are you gonna throw it to break?
All right. This is the ticket. 93.7. I'm with the captain and Bach, and I'm the black shirt. We'll be right back.
From Hollywood to South Central, crazy. Long Beach to Compton, always up to no good. Crazy.
This is Dan Friedman. Between 2010 and 2019, distracted driving caused more than 40,000 car crashes in Nebraska, resulting in over 14,000 severe injuries and deaths. Please keep your eyes on the road. If you have a smartphone, put it away while you're behind the wheel. It will help keep our community safe and secure. This message is brought to you by Friedman Law Offices, helping injured people. It's what we do. It's all we do. Find us at freedomandlaw.com today.
get an immediate look back at the game from the people who know it best. It's the Tanner's Postgame Show and the Final Word live from Tanner's Bar and Grill at 30th and Yankee Hill. Hear from former players and national champions like Jay Foreman, Rashawn Jackson, and Aaron Davis and see what they saw in that day's game. It's the Tanner's Postgame Show and the Final Word, live and in person, home or away at Tanner's Bar and Grill, brought to you by Bauer Infrastructure. Only here on 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
What does continuing education mean to you? At Southeast Community College, it means helping you advance. Whether that's a fundamental course in accounting or marketing to help your business, or helping you become a better leader, SCC can help you take the next step. Financial assistance is available too. Learn more about our business development classes at southeast.edu/continuing education. SCC, your path to personal and professional development.
How's Wingstop sound? Crispy, juicy, classic wings. Made to order, cooked to perfection. And sauced and tossed in those 11 soul-satisfying flavors. Paired with hand-cut seasoned fries, house-made honey mustard, blue cheese, or signature Wingstop ranch. And, of course, spicy Cajun fried corn. I think you've heard enough. Get your flavor delivered at Wingstop.com.
Mike Schaefer here for Trek CBD. It's football season, and that means you're tailgating with friends, or if you're like me, yelling at the TV during Vikings games. Trek CBD has a variety of products that help calm me down during the games, so I don't scare my dog. But in the rare cases that I yell too much, there's CBD products for him, too, and all other pets. Whether you're looking for drinkable Delta 8 seltzers, hemp-derived Delta 9 syrups for your beverages, or anything else, Trek CBD has it all at 84th and Anderson. Trek CBD, CBD done right.
The Lincoln Chamber of Commerce is excited to showcase and celebrate our local businesses. Make plans to attend this year's Lincoln Expo on Wednesday, October 19th from 10 a.m. until 3 p.m. at Pinnacle Bank Arena. Be sure to take time to network and check out the interactive booths from area businesses. Lincoln's Craft Beer Tour returns, plus great door prizes and a free Lincoln t-shirt just for you while supplies last. Admission is free, so make sure to stop by PBA on October 19th. Shop local at the 2022 Lincoln Expo.
Hi, Sean Callahan here for Copple Chevrolet GMC, and things are cooking here in Louisville. We are really hitting on all cylinders right now, and deals are off the charts. We've got a lot more new 2022 and 2023 Chevrolet and GMC inventory than we've had in a long time. So make sure you check us out online, or do even better, stop on in the store and let us show you one in person. Our pre-owned lot is plumb full, so take that short money-saving drive down 144th Street or check us out online at couplecars.com. You'll be glad you did.
Water heater gone? Call Bryant. The price you're quoted is the price you'll pay. And in most cases, same day replacement. Bryant Air Conditioning, Heating, Electrical, and Plumbing. 467-1111.
James Enterprise Incorporated, that company that hauls your gravel, rocks, and material for your farm or construction site, says thank you to the people of the healthcare community for putting yourself in the way of danger to save the public. That is what it means to be a hero and to build a beautiful legacy. This message brought to you by James Enterprise Incorporated. For all your hauling of rock, gravel, and materials, call them at 402-432-6740. That's 402-432-6740.
Hey, this is Ernest Hausman. As a linebacker from Nebraska, I know how important it is to have a strong defense and a great playbook. If you are looking for a solid team to have your back, check out my friends at Burke Brown Law. Burke and Jackson will work with you to create an individualized strategy to bolster your defense.
Hi, this is Burke. Give us a call at 402-606-1441. With locations in Lincoln and Columbus, we're ready to tackle your needs. Find us online at burkebrownlaw.com.
93.7 The Ticket, Fox KFXL Weather.
Brought to you by Bryant Air Conditioning, Heating, Electrical, and Plumbing.
Windy conditions will be in place yet again today as northwest winds could gust over 40. A red flag warning will be in effect this afternoon due to critical fire danger as we see an afternoon high of around 61. A few passing clouds tonight with a low of 40. It will be windy again tomorrow but slightly warmer with a high of 71. I'm meteorologist Tim Wright for 93.7 The Ticket and theticketfm.com.
I grew up hearing that women are bad with money. But like many of you, I spent years paying bills, managing checking accounts, and taking care of my family. So turns out women are pretty good with money after all. And now I'm taking control of my financial future by saving for retirement. It's never too late to start, and there's a great website to help you. check out WeSaySaveIt.org and jumpstart your retirement savings on your budget and your timeline. That's WeSaySaveIt.org, brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
Back with Vershawn Jackson, sponsored by Wingstop.
We're back. The captain. Bob. Smiling in your face.
All right, I'm going to stop there. Paul F. says, I'm a man. I'm 47. Okay, Paul. I know you're taking a jab at the captain. Okay, so Thomas and Lincoln. Deadpool isn't a superhero. He's an anti-hero. Same with Batman. You guys buy that?
Batman has no superpowers.
Where is that?
He got his utility belt.
It's a utility belt.
What are you going to do? He got a lot of goodies. He didn't have enough suit on.
Pull a can opener out.
Huh? He got them bad cars, them vehicles, planes. Hey,
if you're ever online, you got to look at this guy. His name is Ace Vaughn. He's on Facebook and he makes remixes up of the superheroes, and it's real funny. So, and they talk about Batman. They say he's not a superhero. He'll have nothing.
He doesn't have any powers. That's why I like him.
He's a rich guy.
What do you mean? He's got gadgets.
Yeah, he's a scientist.
Whatever you want to call him, he saves the day. I'm Batman.
Yeah.
Would you want to be Batman or Robin?
Oh, Batman.
Do you ever get anybody that wants to just be Robin?
I'd rather be Scooby Doo.
I don't think so.
I'd rather be Scooby Doo before I be Robin.
Oh man, really?
Yeah, Robin doesn't do nothing.
I would be Robin if I knew I could be Batman.
When have you seen Robin fight anybody? He's like,
Robin, get down. What you talking about?
He's always getting in trouble, and then Batman's got to help him, and then the villain escapes. Yeah, that's pretty much the plot of every time.
When did this start happening?
Yeah, Robin was hostile. He didn't want to listen. You know, he wanted to go fight people by himself, show people he was bad. Little boy.
I seem to remember him being his little sidekick though.
See,
I watched it when it wasn't cartoons. I watched it when it was the actual Black Batman and Robin.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. Wow.
Hey, but
that's Adam West. Yeah.
Dragon B said, "Where's Skeletor? Why Skeletor is not getting any love?
Well, nobody messes with no Skeletor." Talk about Skeletor gets no love around here, none. I am a He-Man and the power of Grayskull. I have the power.
Or Thundercats. Thundercats.
Ho!
Are we really talking about?
Not too much.
You ever seen the Littles Box?
I don't think so.
It came on every Saturday around about 12 o'clock. It was the 12 o'clock midday Disney thing.
The Littles.
You ever watch that? The Littles. We are the Littles. They come in. Yeah, look it up. It's the Littles.
What are they?
You was watching kids back then. You was I don't remember the Littles.
Okay, you the same age. Old guy.
My favorite superhero is Nightcrawler from the X-Men. Teleporting would be dope.
That'd be pretty cool.
And Wu-Tang Clan is the best clan.
There you go.
Three seasons. The Littles.
Okay.
It was on for 1983, VJ. I know you watched it. Don't act like you was a bad guy.
I don't think I watched The Littles, man. Send it to me.
Like little gopher looking
guys? I'll confess if I was, but I don't think The Littles impressed me back then. Okay. I was outside doing something, running around, trying to play with my cars or on my big wheel.
We was playing football in the neighborhood about 8.
That too. That's what I'm saying. Pecan Pie says Mighty Mouse is the greatest superhero. Captain Planet. Dark, Wilmite. Will, listen, hey, listen to Wilmite. Darkwing Duck. Wilmite's probably, listen, Wilmite's probably like 58. Darkwing Duck. Why, Wilmite? Tell me why. Give it to me, Will. I know this is my boy, Wilmite. Tell me why you like Darkwing Duck. Because Darkwing Duck is interesting, but for the favorite?
It's a good Robbie, mention.
It's
a good mention, though. I forgot about Darkwing Duck.
Yeah, I like I said, I like Darkwing Duck, but I don't know if I could go with him for the favorite, though. Like,
I don't know.
Could you imagine Darkwing Duck against Superman? L. Yes,
not good.
Bye, Darkwing Duck. Back to cartoon land. Robbie in Iowa says, I was more of a He-Man Master of the Universe guy. Robbie in Parkersburg, Iowa. Shout out to you, man. We got fans everywhere. Captains. Somebody said that, I must have missed that. The Captain's Planet or Captain Planet. Who the heck is Captain Planet?
Oh, no.
You don't know Captain Planet?
No.
He and his, like, friends helped save the world against, like, people that were littering and stuff.
Bro.
They'd all have rings they'd put together, and it made them more powerful.
Yeah, like Johnny Quest, huh?
Hey, so somebody
the magic puppet?
Let me ask this real quick. 2895 says, VJ, did the coach that recruited you come visit you in the bricks? You know what that's? Well, you know what that is, Bach?
The bricks, huh?
You don't?
Yeah, he came up in there.
What's the bricks, black shirt?
It's the projects.
It's the projects, Bach. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Coach Osborne came up to the into the projects. The gang members told him, hey, he stay right there. You know what I'm saying? he over there, y'all. And then everybody was outside my house. Everybody, it was surreal. There was a lot of just people outside, you know, me and my family inside. You know what I mean? And here's Coach Osborne in the projects. I wish we could have a picture of that. I need a picture of that, man.
Yeah.
Nah, Logan Fontenelle Projects, a.k.a. Vietnam Projects.
I bet you he probably done went some places worse because Coach Osborne, he'll go anywhere.
I'm telling you.
He would go anywhere to get them players.
Right? Hey, that's a great question, though, 2895. He actually, he's the only one.
Yeah.
He was the only one that came there. Nobody else. There was not another coach. No. Uh-uh. No. Coach Osborne.
So everybody else makes you like a visit them, unofficial visit or official visit to them?
I don't know. I don't remember how that worked. I only saw him when I went there.
Yeah.
But they never – I talked to some of the assistant coaches on the phone, but I'm saying that actually came to my house.
Yeah.
Coach Osborne and Coach Osborne only. Period. Dot the end. I didn't get anybody else. Now, I would imagine that the guys that were, you know, out – You know, and listen, Coach Dan Young would come to my basketball games. So I'm not saying that. I said actually come to my house.
Yeah.
A different story. Or to our brick apartment.
Yeah, Coach Osborne, he comes like after the bowl game, he comes right there the next day. He'll be there. He came to my house after they beat Miami. He was at my house the next day. So I guess he was making his rounds.
Houston Pepper Champion says if Batman and superhero is a superhero, then Bezos and Musk are just martial arts class away from being superheroes.
They're pretty close, yeah.
Did you used to watch the Bozo show when you was little, VJ?
Come on, man. You know I watched the Bozo Bozo the Clown?
Yeah, yeah.
Come on, man.
Him and Cookie. I watched
the Bozo show. That and the Cookie Monster. What was the Cookie Monster? Who was on it? What was that? That was the Muppets. What was the Cookie Monster on? I don't remember.
It's on Sesame Street.
Oh my God. You
Tyler, you are just stop it, Tyler. Be nice. Dusty75 says Iron Man doesn't have superhero, but he doesn't have powers, but he's still super.
Well, he had enough money to buy it. So baby Batman should have did that.
Anyway. Oh my goodness, there's so many. We didn't open up the Pandora's box. Is it going in right now? Eric says, really showing your age with this VJ Batman talk. Dude, let me just tell you something. I would love to just waste all the time and then get to the Nebraska game. And then get to the Nebraska game again. and then get to the Nebraska game again. I could tell you all the, what we could do here, there, and everywhere, but it, people are enjoying it. It's such a party pooper. Radio is not always meant to be one-dimensional. Is it, Pop?
No, we can talk about other things. There's always the one guy that yells at you to talk sports if you veer off too much.
I literally got 25 texts in a row. Montana Husker says Wonder Woman. See? That might be a young lady. I don't know. Limitless money is superpower, Jesse the Plumber says.
There you go.
Limitless money, black shirt. what would you do, black shirt, if you had limitless money?
I'll have my own island.
There you go.
Get away from all the people.
Huh? What would you black, you people?
Black shirt,
you
black
watch shirt your island. Mouth.
Black shirt island.
Oh. Well, who would get invited?
Nobody.
Would you still be on the captain every weekday from?
No.
I
will have my own show.
Oh, okay.
You'd be broadcasting from the island.
Yeah.
By yourself.
Every day.
Bach.
That's sad. If I had limitless money, I'd never stop traveling. I'd move around everywhere, go to all the big games.
Hey, Corey Matley says this probably to you, Bob. Batman could have maybe got superpowers if it was just one big Dakota.
Maybe, yeah. Plus, some of his like his villains get superpowers, like Clayface, or like you know, he just turns into a giant clay man and he can throw stuff around. So there are superpowers within the Batman universe, but for some reason, he doesn't get them.
Listen, VJ, were you watching the Little Rascals? Yeah, I was watching the Little Rascals, man. I you know what, Alfalfa, you know what I mean? Buckwheat.
Spanky.
Oh, Spanks. Come on, man.
Darla?
Oh, I got some funny deals with that. But tomorrow, our pregame show, we'll be talking all things Purdue. Talk about what they got inside out, defense, offense, O'Connell, rest of these guys. I'm still looking for a great game. I'm looking for us to play lights out, to play disciplined football. Listen, it's Thursday. What else you got to do but to wait until you wake up? And it's Friday. That's right, a day in the wake up. The black shirt, Bob, Captain, thanks for another day, man.
Breakfast tacos, brisket tacos, pork tacos, chicken tacos. You hungry yet? I can keep going.